there's this tension between an extreme reaction on the part of white people who feel like they need to apologize for everything their ancestors ever did. And I saw a video of a black protester, and she saw, and she panned the camera to two white protesters spray painting a building. And she said, hold up. She said, stop that. We didn't ask you to do that. We do not need you to spray paint buildings and do this. We're out here peacefully protesting. You're going to leave and everybody's going to think that we did that. And so there, that's one extreme. The other side of it that I very much appreciate, and here again, this is attention, is when white men, particularly in authority, will speak up intelligently with emotional intelligence and articulately speak up and not be defensive, but just call it for what it is. This is blatantly wrong. This was murder. And I have a former coach who did that, and I messaged him and I said, thank you for this. He wrote a long, and I know you can get to where there's too much noise, and I, especially on social media, but it, for me, it does matter. It does mean something when my white pastor goes on his Facebook Live devotional every day and prays about this and brings it up and says, church, we must do better. Everybody expects, you know, the black pastors to do that, which obviously we should, but and I'm not, I think the extreme of white silence is white violence. I don't know about all that, but I will say silence can be culpable. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yes.